So, okay, let's be real. The Claude Agent SDK is probably the biggest thing Anthropic shipped for devs like us, and somehow almost nobody's breaking it down for solo indie builders. This isn't a walkthrough or a code along. I'm not demoing features. I'm breaking down why this Agentic SDK actually flips the game for people like us who build, ship, and fix everything on our own. Just real quick, so I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS trenches for 8 years now, started out freelancing, helping clients ship their ideas, learning the hard way what actually works and what just burns you out. But after DubDub25, I went all in on solo dev. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started building everything out in public, and lately, Crafters Lab is where I've been putting all my energy. It isn't just another tutorial site or Discord to scroll past. This is my real home base for solo devs who treat AI like a teammate, not just a vending machine. Every deep dive guide, app blueprint, design workflow, even the exact Notion team spaces I use daily, they're all live here. SwiftBrain, the full agents ops, and even my own playbook with real MD files. It's all finally in one place on a private indie first platform. If you want real systems, real code, and a real community for solo devs, not just another AI clone farm, that's what I'm building. And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterslab.dev. All right, let's start here. Prompts are nice, but as a solo dev, they only get you so far. With prompts, it's all linear. You throw in a request, you get a response, maybe you chain a few together if you're fancy, but it's always you in the middle, stitching together every step. That works until it really doesn't. Because solo dev life isn't a straight line. It's loops, redos, missing info, late night gotchas, and stuff that just breaks at the worst time. A prompt is a recipe, but an agent is a chef who can actually improvise. The SDK flips that on its head. Instead of thinking in A to B prompts, you give your agent a goal, some tools, and let it figure out the path, doubling back, trying alternatives, even pausing for missing info instead of just plowing ahead and shipping something broken. And honestly, once you see that play out, like when an agent realizes a web search failed and decides to retry or asks for more data before moving forward, you start to get it. It's not about linear scripts, it's about something that can actually work the way you do. A little messy, always adapting. And for solo devs, that's not a buzzword. That's the difference between a feature that lands on the first try and yet another late night code cleanup. Here's where it gets real: tool use. If you've only ever played with prompt-based AI, you're used to asking for help, getting a wall of text back, and then having to jump over to your shell or Xcode or some random script just to finish the job. With agents, and especially with the Claude Agent SDK, you can actually hand over your weird, bespoke tools, shell scripts, Python snippets, custom Swift utilities, even random deployment hacks you've accumulated over years of indie shipping. You don't just describe what you want. You make those scripts first-class citizens in the agent's world. The SDK makes this weirdly frictionless. You define a tool, register it, and now the agent can call it at any point in its workflow, like not just at the end, but as part of figuring out what to do next. That means your agent can deploy to test flight, run a build, spin up a dev container, check Firebase logs. Whatever little ritual you have as a solo builder, the agent can actually do it. Not just talk about it. The more you wire in, the more the agent starts to feel like an actual teammate, one who actually knows your toolkit, not just the theory. I can't overstate how different this feels once you get it set up. For me, the first time an agent ran my script to reset test data, then double-check the logs, and only then tried the next action, it was wild. You're not babysitting the process, you're actually getting support, not more chores. That's the kind of automation solo devs need. Not magic, just real flexible help that's tuned to your world. And yeah, so let's just talk about this for a second, right? Because session memory, this is where the SDK actually gets kind of wild for solo devs. Like, you know that pain where you're pasting output from prompt A into prompt B, juggling bits of context, hoping you didn't lose something along the way. I mean, that's just real solo dev life, right? It's always, wait, what did I just tell this thing? Did it forget about that edge case? Am I going to have to re-explain everything for the third time today? And honestly, it gets old fast. But okay, so with the Agent SDK, you don't have to babysit anymore. That's the thing. Suddenly you get agents that just remember, they actually hold the thread, loop back, follow up, and keep the context alive. So you're not stuck playing telephone with your own prompts. I don't know, it just feels like you're having a real back and forth now. Not a bunch of disconnected chats, but an actual conversation that stays on track. You ever wish your tools would just pick up where you left off? Yeah, this is it. And for real, when you start building bots, assistants, coding helpers, whatever you're making, that's not just a nice to have. That's what makes the whole next level possible. Follow-ups, little, wait, can you clarify that? Moments, even jumping back a few steps if something gets missed. Your AI teammate starts to feel like, you know, a teammate, not just a vending machine for answers. So for solo builders, this is honestly what closes the gap. Like all those wild ideas you had but never shipped because it was just too much glue work. Now you can actually build them. Bots that remember the user journey, tools that know what's been fixed, stuff that doesn't just start over every single time. And yeah, no, totally. This is the part that makes solo projects punch way above their weight. I mean, come on, it's kind of wild to see it in action. All right, so yeah, if you actually stuck around to the end of this, honestly, thank you. I know this wasn't a flashy tutorial or some endless code walkthrough, but you know, that's not really what we do here. If you're deep in the indie trenches, shipping on your own, poking at new tools like the Claude Agent SDK, or just trying to figure out how the heck to keep your workflow sane, I hope this breakdown gave you a couple ideas, or at least made you feel a little less stuck. And yeah, if you ever want to swap stories, share something wild you built, or just vent about agents going rogue, check out crafterslab.dev. That's kind of become my real home base for this whole solo dev thing. Real workflows, actual system docs, the playbook, even the Notion setups I use every day, all in one spot. I mean, for what it's worth, there's a whole crew of us figuring it out over there. And it's way more fun than just yelling at your IDE alone at midnight. So if you found this even a tiny bit useful, maybe throw a like or send it to another indie builder who's sick of shallow AI takes. And if you're actually building with this SDK, I genuinely want to see it. Drop a comment, DM, whatever. The best stuff always comes from the weirdest indie experiments. Okay, so yeah, I'm Daniel. This is Solo Swift Crafter, and I'll see you over at crafterslab.dev. Keep crafting, stay curious, and I don't know, maybe let your agents break a few things just to see what happens. Peace.